Hello again, and welcome back to another one. And today we have a couple of topics to cover, including another certification for Eminem, this time in the United States as a featured artist. And a few days ago, Crook was on a podcast where he spoke about getting a phone call where Suge supported his move to work with Eminem, and the report on this on Twitter caused a bit of confusion based on history. But Crook stepped in to clear the air, and before we dive in, if you enjoy content like this, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and find me on social media at @ETLifestyle_web. So first of all, Big Sean's No Favors featuring Eminem was just certified platinum in the United States, a song that was heavily criticized on social media when it dropped, and over on Reddit, under the thread, Big Sean and Eminem's No Favors is now certified platinum in the United States, a user reacted with, "I really don't understand how people can hate on this song, such a banger." But on the other end, a user elaborates, "Great bit, but Eminem attacked the mic with a very rough flow. I really don't enjoy that delivery." So it's split reactions to this day, but some even go as far as say his best verse in 2017. But although opinions may vary, the fact of the matter is that it's now platinum, despite being a non-single. And for those who missed it, Not A Like featuring Royce da 5'9" was also certified silver in the United Kingdom on the same day. Save your comments on No Favors for later, and we move on to the next point. So a few days ago, the report that sparked reactions stated, Death Row founder Suge Knight encouraged King Crook to work with Eminem, and that prompted reactions like this. Was that before or after he made that voicemail for Nick Cannon threatening in quote, "Eminem or whatever your name is"? And on this, another user added, rolling on the floor laughing, is that after he pretended not to know the GOAT in the Invitation dumb song, "It Ain't Even a Diss or Anything Related to Music, LOL"? And upon reading the reactions, most were either joking or going off based on reading just the headline, so Crook reacted to it with "True Story." And this is where the report came from, when Crook was on The Line podcast where he made the claim.
And he called me one day when I was at Eminem's studio, standing in the kitchen, and he like, "Yo, Crook, I heard you with the white boy." That's what he called him, you know. He's like, "I heard you with the white boy." He said, you know,
"Oh, with
the white boy." He said, "I'm glad you with the white boy." He said, "I'll never stand in the way of any progress in your career." He said, "Eminem is one of the greatest lyricists, and so are you, and he's gonna understand what to do with you. So stay over there rocking with him, and it's all love."
But Crook's reaction to the report only resulted in more questions like this. Really? That's very confusing, considering how much it sounded like Suge doesn't like M. Can you shed more light on that? And some referred to reports from years ago like this. Suge Knight allegedly tried to have Eminem ended at 2001 SOS Awards. And another user brought up the Nick Cannon drama to Crook with, "Hold up, Crook, didn't we hear an audio recording of Suge in a call with Nick Cannon saying, in quotes, 'Check this out, Eminem, whatever your name is, right, you know, I don't never do no talking, but Nick is family, this is your invitation,' end quote, like he didn't know who he was." But Crook stepped in to clarify with this, "I can't speak for him, I can only tell you what he told me." And in reaction to Crook, one user shed some more light on the angle Suge was probably coming from with that phone call Crook was talking about, the user states. "It's only confusing if you think you have to like someone to know a smart business move." And Crook approved the next reaction. Suge to a lot of people is that infamous character. They didn't know him or work with him the way you did. As a fan of hip hop, sometimes it's hard to tell what's real and what's urban legend. So what are your thoughts? Tell us below, and see you on the next one.